Hey guys, Julian here from IDD, and I'm here in IDS 2023, and I'm with Kyle from Pearl AI, one of the leading diagnostic AI software out there. And as the world has blown up recently with ChatGPT and all of that news, this man has been doing AI a lot longer. So Kyle, can you give us a bit of a background on Pearl and yeah, the reason how it came about?
Yeah, so, you know, it came about between me and our CEO, my co-founder. We had a conversation about how we can utilize AI in dentistry. And so we started incubating this idea in 2015. We spun out the company in 2019, and we've been going gangbusters ever since all around the world.
It's a great story. So AI did exist before 2023, people.
Yeah, that's right. I think now it seems like it's everywhere because of DALL-E and ChatGPT, right? But yeah, we've been working on this since 2015.
There you go. And what is Pearl AI and how do you use it in your clinic? What does it do for your life?
Yeah, so we're a computer vision company. So we read dental imaging. So that is radiographs. As we take radiographs, we have immediate patient-facing pathology detection. So looking at caries and bone loss and calculus and periparietal lucencies, notable margins, existing restorations. We can segment out where the enamel, dentin, pulp, cementum, bone, everything is, so we can index that. Now, why that's important is because us dentists are pretty good, but we're not perfect. And the AI is pretty good, and it's not perfect. When you bring the two of us together, we get to these superhuman levels of diagnostics. In addition, it helps to build trust with the patient. So unfortunately, we have a trust issue in dentistry, but when you show a patient this third-party AI system that has no incentive to find anything, found a carry, and I agree with it, they can have that form of trust. Not only that, but you can make it visual. So instead of pointing to a black and white image and saying, you see this little gray smudge, you can say, oh, you see this pink little outline. You see that's getting close to the green. That green is the dentin. That's the sensitive part of your tooth. So you can have these intelligent conversations with your patients, build trust, and allow them to make the right decision for their oral health.
That's exciting because patient communication is challenging. And any visual aids, as we know, with smile simulators, ortho simulators, all of those things improve the patient understanding treatment. And obviously the unfortunate, I guess, impression people have of an ulterior motive with some dentists of trying to overprescribe, this gives it a third party to point the finger at.
Yeah, we call it second opinion. You know, it's a built-in second opinion. And someone was just asking me, why do you call it second opinion? Well, it's because I'm the first opinion. You know, it's ultimately up to me. But I have this built-in second opinion to where I can even tell the patient, you know, this is what I think, this is what AI thinks. And together, this is what I think the treatment plan should be. So building trust, allowing something to be, like you said, there's no incentive. You know, unfortunately, we have financially driven diagnosis. And our patients know that. The more we diagnose, the more money we make, which isn't great when you're trying to build trust with a patient. So having something that's non-biased, third party, build trust, show them visually, really builds value for the dentist.
Absolutely. It's very exciting. And I can see a lot of people can find benefit of this. I've even had some people talking about AI and saying that they can see in the future, it could even look like it would be malpractice to not use AI to possibly pick up things that a tired human after, you know, a long day of surgery, you're looking at something and you just might skip through or miss just innocently things. But this is that backup that helps you look at every possible indication.
Yeah. You know, I think this will be a true utility in dentistry. And I say utility, how we think of water or power. It's just going to be there. It's going to be very normal. You know, right now AI is exciting and it's new, but very soon, I mean, the next 2-3 years, it will be very normal. Everybody will have it. Nobody will look at radiographs without the assistance of AI. I mean, there's a lot of technology we think now that was so amazing when it came out that is just so normal. And I think it's going to be a very steep trend with that. In just a few years, everybody will have it.
Absolutely. I am seeing that myself as well. It can only speed up diagnosis and make it easier. I mean, how long does Pearl AI take to actually process a radiograph and and provide a second opinion?
Yeah, about 8 to 30 seconds, depending on the internet. So I always say, if you're taking a series of images, by the time you take your second image, the first one will be up.
That's pretty fast. I don't think any dentist could compete with that. That's exciting. So I see you've also got practice intelligence there. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so practice intelligence takes what we do with second opinion, which is indexing all the images and cross-references it with what's happening in the practice management system. So we may find caries. We're going to look in the treatment plan and say, is this patient treatment plan for filling inlay, onlay, crown, or extraction? And if they're not, then we may say, hey, doc, this is an opportunity. So it's allowing you to treat your patients better, make more money, you know, decrease your liability, and ultimately have a better business.
So Kyle, there's obviously a lot of importing and exporting images and things. So am I having to export out of my software and import into a separate install for this?
Yeah, good question. So none of that has to happen. We put an agent on your server, and every time you take a new image, we grab it, analyze it, and show it on the front end. So there's nothing like drag or dropping. There's nothing manual that needs to happen once the install is there. So you take your image, just pull it up in our software.
Okay, that's pretty cool. And you support most major imaging software platforms?
Yeah, about 80% of the market. If it's some, you know, really exotic one, then we may not. But most of the big ones that people use, we support.
That's exciting. And on the 3D front, CBCT, DICOM files, are you looking at using AI with that as well?
Yeah, we've been training on that for about the last 2 years and hope to have that out by, you know, early next year.
Takes a while. These things have to work out. You got to give them data, right? Yeah. So you've got some beta testers just feeding you data and practicing diagnosis?
Yeah, that's right. So how AI works is you collect the data first, annotate all the data by hand with humans, then feed it into the computer and start to see the output, start changing the output, retraining it, making it better over time. So it's like training a baby how to walk. You know, eventually they, when they start, they're crawling, and then they try to get up and they fall and they fall and they fall and they fall. And eventually they figure it out, you know, and it's kind of how AI is. And it's been crazy to see this process happen. It's really like seeing a baby grow. Like I have two kids and it's the same kind of process, teaching, reteaching. No, this is blue. This is red. This is blue. This is red. Eventually they get it. But you have to give them a lot of input and practice, and over time they get better.
So you've got some CBCT experts working through this and analyzing the AI output and then refining it and teaching it to get more accurate.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. A lot of the experts come in the training phase. And then once they've annotated it, then it's over to our computer vision engineers. And their thing is to train it and make it do what the human was doing automatically.
Sounds great. So how much does all this cost?
So in Europe, the retail price is $299 a month. And that's how it works.
US dollars?
US dollars, it's around the same thing. Yeah.
And for $299, what do we get? Unlimited detections? Is there a certain number of radiographs? How does that work?
Yeah. So for $299 in Europe, you're getting second opinion. Okay. Practice intelligence. We just are launching in the UK. And in Europe, we have it in North America. In North America, it's around $500 a month. And so with that, you're getting second opinion and practice intelligence. And it's around, you know, up to 2,500 images a month, which usually is around 1 to 2 doctors per office. Yeah.
And if we have, say, 8 doctors in a large practice, what would we do?
Yeah, then we do a more customized cost structure.
Okay. Sounds good. And has there been any new releases at IDS for the software or just creating more awareness?
Yeah, I mean, the big announcement was that we're bringing practice intelligence to the UK and Europe.
Okay, exciting times. We're from Australia or New Zealand. Is there anything down under?
Yep, we're actually expanding and we have a lot of stuff happening in Australia and New Zealand right now, working with some of the big DSOs down there and getting everything going. So yeah, we're already there.
Exciting. AI in dentistry, it's here, it's now, it's happening. And check out Pearl AI and see if it's right for you and your practice. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.